Today we have a monthly meeting for our HIV support groups. We started our HIV work on 2007. And I do remember that there were only 5 participants at our very first meeting. Today, about 150 or 200 people are gathering together to our monthly meeting. And altogether we have about 700 clients in our small groups. At the moment, we have 20 small groups, and each of those groups have a meeting once a week. And once a month, we invite all small groups to our church. Program contains Bible teaching, and then each time our medical assistant gives health lecture, and there is time for questions concerning HIV. And in the end, everybody get lunch. I've been doing mainly the Bible teaching sessions in this group, or sometimes our Finnish visitors also. During first years I was using a program called Embracing Life. It is a program for those who have any life-threatening illnesses. And it contains some very good topics, example, forgiveness, the beginning of healing, or healing from shame and self-hatred.
And then they should call Baal, they should call their own God, that God would lit the fire.
You see, there is this, whoever sees, some strange humankind. Mm-hmm. Let's see who can take the jacket off. Okay?
Malawian loves drama. Our clients have often their own drama performances, and today the teaching is done by drama. Sun and Win were fighting. Which one of them are stronger? Who gets jacket off from Paspaye? The wind is sure that she is the stronger one, but gentle warmth of the sun wins. The monthly meeting of our support groups is finished. Everybody had their lunch already and people have gone home. But I asked the coordinator of the groups to stay so I can ask some questions.
But what is your name?
My name is Alex Sombo.
And you are the coordinator of all the groups in Kulambe area and even Chiringa area. And what you are exactly doing?
I'm organizing different kinds of meetings for the support groups concerning HIV and AIDS in this area. When we get together, there are always new people joining in. They are not hiding their situation. Then we form new support groups where the participants can encourage each other and they are talking about how important it is to take the medicine.
And when did you start that? When did you start this task? When, from how long time you've been? How long time you've been the coordinator?
This is my sixth year as a coordinator.
Okay. Yeah. What do you think? Have you seen any changes? How people are now telling about things that they are HIV positives, or how other people are reacting? Have you seen any changes during these years?
Many things have changed. First, when we didn't have the support groups, the HIV positives even wanted to kill themselves. Before the support groups, people talked a lot of bad things about us. But now, many of us can work again, and they can live normal lives despite HIV. The support groups have helped us a lot.
Is
it possible, could you tell what year you were diagnosed?
I got the diagnosis in 2005. It was March.
Okay. Yeah. And did you get medicine straight away, or did you wait, or?
I got the medicine very quickly, already in the April of the same year.
Yeah. Okay. Then today, when our medical assistant was there and he was answering some questions. Actually, you were asking these questions that concerning albinos. So are there still that kind of faith that if somebody have sex with albino, they can be healed? Or it's quite a weird thing to ask. So are there still that kind of faith?
Before, people believed that a sexual relationship with an albino can cleanse the blood and heal from this illness. But now that we have education, things have changed, and in general, people don't believe this anymore. But still, in some areas, like in Solo, this belief is still alive. But here in Kulambe and Nasombe, people don't believe it anymore.
Okay, and I knew that you were asking that question like for everybody. I knew that you wanted to make sure that nobody think anymore like that.
Yes, I just wanted to make sure to everybody that nobody should believe this kind of thing anymore.
Can you also tell something about Good Samaritan program? Because I remember that we were asked to choose 40 people from this big group, and it was Bible Society who was giving that task. And so tell something what it is and what you've been doing.
Yes, I would like to thank Bible Society that they asked to choose 40 people to be Good Samaritans. Before, we were treated as second-class citizens, but now we are asked to teach others. These people are teaching in churches and villages. First, those who had HIV were not given any responsibility. But now, many kinds of teaching and education is happening through this program. Today, we are sharing information and going around helping the poorest ones. We help them in many ways, like getting them the basic necessities, like soap. if needed, we can help them by digging fields and maintaining or building a house. People in this area have really benefited from the Bible Society's program. Life of many has improved a lot, and people have united again. This program is really working well.
And when medical assistant or nurse comes to meeting, clients have lots of questions. It often comes to my mind that we have here plenty of information, but some information is not updated. Komaso pena patemeke pakali magazi magazini magazalo
welani ndiyeno pamene po chirombo chitakulowa what do you say about HIV situation in Malawi?
Okay, HIV situation in Malawi is very pathetic because the prevalence rate is 8 to 15%, so at every 100 people is 50 people who are infected with HIV. So the HIV prevalence rate is like that in Malawi, and more especially here in the southern of Malawi. So the situation is very bad because many people are infected with the virus, and there are a lot of orphans which are present in this country because of this HIV pandemic.
Okay, so you were saying that it's more here in the southern region. Do you know why is that?
Yeah, personally I can say something about that because it's more often in southern Malawi because there are a lot of companies and many people here in the southern region of Malawi. They are at least poor. They are more poor than those people in the southern regions. So when these people go into the states, they work there. They get some relationships, mm-hmm. and then they get affected.
Okay. Yeah. So what is government doing in these days?
The government is doing a lot of work in mm-hmm. this situation because they are giving antiretroviral drugs, which are free of charge. They don't pay anything.
Yeah.
Yeah, and also they are giving CPT, which is bactrim, mm-hmm. to those who are infected, and also they are giving supplementary fees, like in Kunipala and some other fees, to pregnant women and those who are lactating.
So if you think about last years, can you see that things have changed?
Yes.
Like which way?
In the past years, the antiretroviral drugs were being sold even in the government hospitals. Mm-hmm. But as of now, it's free. Nobody is buying the drugs. Mm-hmm. So it has really assisted the community mm-hmm. because many people were dying without the medicine. They were, because Malawi is a poor country, mm-hmm. they were supposed to take the medicine, but because they didn't have any money to buy the medicine, so it was very pathetic. People were dying like flies, mm-hmm. but now I think the government has done a lot of things, a lot of good things. People are taking the drugs, so things are good now.
Is there enough medicines for everybody?
As of now, I can say yes.
If somebody is diagnosed to be HIV positive, also the side of medicine, people need a good food.
Yes.
So is that state fine, what do you
think?
Yeah,
it's fine, because with the HIV itself drops the immunity of the mm-hmm. person. So if somebody is not eating a lot, mm-hmm. is not eating good food, mm-hmm. I think with the virus, the condition deteriorates and somebody can die as fast mm-hmm. as possible.
Yeah.
But when the government is giving the medicine and also giving some supplementary fees mm-hmm. to those people who are affected,
okay.
I think it is assisting the people in nutritionally and their health is good because of that.
So I can hear from your statement that there are kind of hope.
Yes, there's really hope.
Yeah. Yeah. How about the percentage? Is it gone like down?
Yeah, it is gone down because previously, like in the 2000, yeah, the previous rate was very high. It was like 25%.
Okay.
But because of this program which the government is doing, yeah, it has gone down. As I said earlier on, that it is now at 15%.
I think that audience are interested what we are doing in this clinic, so can you a little bit tell?
Okay, in this clinic we are following government protocols. So in this program of HIV management, we are doing many things, and some other organizations like Teaching International is also doing its part to this clinic, because it is providing us, in conjunction with the government, some antiretroviral drugs, bactrim, and also it's providing some supplemental feeds to malnourished people. It is also, when we find somebody, or when we find a malnourished child, or when we find somebody whose health status is not all that good, the clinic does its part by providing some food and also some milk for those children. So we are doing a nice job as a clinic.
Okay.
We are on our way to a meeting of HIV positive children. It is Saturday and we are traveling by two motorbikes. We just met somebody who warned us that there is a police on the road. And at the same time I found out that one of our motorbike drivers had forgot to pay the custom fee when he bought his bike from Mozambique. So we decided to take a side road. Better days of this road are gone. And we just reached a bridge, which can be called bridge only by good imagination. But no problem, we get over it by help of other travelers. This place is about 20 kilometer distance from our village. And the meeting of HIV positive children is here. Among them are also other children, and so only part of these children are suffering HIV, but we don't point them from the group. This meeting is every Saturday, and of course food is served after each meet, and they have two volunteer teachers here. The teaching mainly concentrates how to live with HIV or how to protect yourself from the virus. So children get good information in their early age and very important information when thinking of living circumstances over here.
He's a big man.
Drama tells story of Israelites who left from Egypt. Pharaoh's army is chasing them and they have just reached Red Sea. Situation is very bad. Pharaoh's army is close.
Moses is praying his God. He is hitting his stick down.
Moses resorts to God. Red Sea opens and Israelites get to another side by walking through the sea.
Exactly. Water opens. There comes a new road.
Moses resorts to God. Red Sea opens and Israelites get to another side by walking through the sea.
They are free.
In the end, I was teaching how everyone can resort to God when there is bad life situation. Of the HIV children ends. Each time after the HIV children or adults meeting, I feel so good. There are so much hope and joy present in each meeting.